Figma is the hottest design tool right now. It's similar to Sketch and Adobe XD in a lot of ways, but slightly different and better. Check the comparison video if you want to learn more about similarities and differences. In this video, you will find all the things you need to create your first design in Figma. Let's get started. Let's begin with account creation. Go to figma.com. You can access Figma from browser, but for best experience, I recommend using desktop app. You can find it under resources or in the footer. Next thing you need to do is to decide right plan for you. In the free plan, you can create 3 projects and as many files as you need, but you will miss important features like team libraries, unlimited projects, and version history. If you are studying in college or universities, I have good news for you. You can get pro features by signing up for a student account. Once you decide a plan, install and open desktop app. Click on create account if you are new. As I already have an account, I'll directly log in. This is the landing page that you can see by default. Let's understand how our design files are organized. You can create any number of files in the drafts for practice. You have to create a team before creating a project. You can do that by clicking New Team. Once added, select the team and add new projects. Under project, you can add new file or you can import your existing sketch file. Things are slightly rearranged in latest community beta update. New team is moved from bottom to top right. You also have a new community beta tab. Community is excellent and fastest way to learn Figma. If this tab is not visible to you, it's probably because it's still under beta. You can sign up to community using the link in the description below. You can find UI kits, components, design files, and lots of plugins under this tab. I'll cover this in more details in upcoming videos. The editor interface has 4 main areas. Big gray area in the middle is canvas. This is where we do our design work. Then we have toolbar on the top. On the left hand side we have left hand panel or layers panel. And finally on the right hand side we have properties panel. Let's learn about those in detail. We have infinite gray canvas to begin with. You can add anything on this canvas. Add images, draw shapes, or even write. I use this to collect my ideas and inspirations for the project. You can also change the background color of this canvas. I like to keep it dark as designs stand out well on that. To prototype or preview anything on this canvas, we must add frames. Let's see how we can do that in the next section. Toolbar has all the tools that we need to design, review, and share. To begin with, you have searchable menu. You can search for rulers, grid, or anything that you have in mind. Then we have move and scale tools. They behave exactly like the names. Next, we have frames. Frames are just like artboards where you can start designing for specific device or sizes. Once you click on frames, you can see a lot of default sizes. Pick the one of your choice. Let's add some iPhone 10 frames on the canvas. You can also create custom frame size by selecting frame or keyboard shortcut F and dragging frame area on the canvas. Third way of adding frame is by selecting the object, right click, click on frame selection, and now frame will wrap the object. After frames, we have our design tools. Using this one, we can create all standard vector shapes like rectangle, lines, arrows, circle, and polygon. Let's add them one by one. Looks perfect. Now let's try paste images. Using paste image, you can copy paste images inside different shapes. All you have to do is select images from file manager, click open, and now click on all the shapes one by one. That's it. Easy, isn't it? If all these basic shapes are not enough, we have paint tool where we can draw custom vector shapes. Vector tools in Figma are very advanced than competition. Apart from creating basic shapes and curves, we can create something called vector network, where you can connect one node to multiple nodes. To add curves, select node first, then select bend tool or use keyboard shortcut command on Mac or control on Windows. By default, curves will be symmetric. If you need to add different angles, then hold option key on Mac or alt key on Windows and drag the handle. You will use these tools a lot. Pencil tool is used for freehand drawings, which is then converted into vector path. Next one is text tool. Just select and click inside a frame to create point text. Point text is free flowing text which just goes on and on. This is perfect for short titles, labels, etc. If you need text inside limited area, then select text tool and instead of clicking, drag the area in which you want to write. Text now respects the boundaries. You can also choose auto height to make it dynamic. You can use hand tool to pan around the canvas. You can do the same by holding spacebar and dragging canvas with the mouse. Last one in the toolbar is comment section. We will use this a lot for reviews, collaboration, and tracking changes. We'll check this later in detail. Middle section of toolbar is dynamic. When nothing is selected, you can see file name and project name. Use drop-down to save file, add versions, delete, make a duplicate, and so much more. When you select any element on the screen, you can see different options like edit object, create component, use as a mask, or crop images, or create link. On top right, you can see all collaborators actively working on the file. You can use share button to share your designs with stakeholders, designers, and developers. Last in the toolbar section are preview options. Use drop down to change zoom settings, toggle layout grids, rulers, outline views, etc. This is truly dynamic panel. Those properties change depending upon the element selected on canvas. Some properties are common for all, such as alignment options, XY positions, width and height, rotation, and constraints. Let's see some common properties in detail. Select this rectangle here and try different alignment options. You should note that objects are aligned within the container frame. Let's check this behavior again by moving this entire frame inside a bigger frame. Rectangle still aligns itself as per frame in which it was placed. This is super useful in design. I'll share some tips about this in upcoming videos. Fill properties. This is probably the most widely used property. We have various fill options here in Figma. We have image fill, solid color fill, and various gradient fill options. Selecting desired color from color fill or its hex value is so easy. You can also save style by clicking this plus icon, give a proper name to this color, and save. Once added, you can use this color for other elements as well very easily. To add stroke or borders, click this plus icon. You can now decide color and thickness. A quickest way to change thickness is by dragging mouse when you see this resize cursor. You can also change border position as inside, outside, or center. We have four effects in Figma: drop shadow, inner shadow, layer blur, and background blur. Drop shadow gives a feeling as if object is floating in the air. Inner shadow gives a feeling as object is pressed. Let's try blur effects now. Layer blur blurs the selected layer. You can change the intensity. Background blur works in the opposite way. It blurs the background layer. To see that in action, we have to reduce the opacity around 50%. Let's adjust the blur value to get desired effect. Left side panel or layers panel helps us organize our designs even more. You can organize your designs in pages. This keeps our canvas clean and structured. I usually create different pages for different modules or different devices. On top, we can toggle between layers and assets. Assets panel hosts all the components. For those who don't know what symbols or components are, here's an explanation. Components are reusable groups in designs. Let's see them in action by creating a navigation bar for our screens. Once our icons are placed, we can add them inside a frame. Now magic happens as you click on Create Component. Now this component is visible in Assets panel. Drag this tab bar on two other screens. You can override some properties in these components like fill colors. Now try rearranging icons. As we created a component first, design changes in all three screens. How cool is that? This component feature alone increased efficiency by 10 times. Nowadays, designing just the screen is not enough. We should be able to test designs with real users. And to test designs, prototyping is an important step. Adding interactions to our designs is very easy. Toggle from Design to Prototype from Properties panel. All you have to do is select layer where you want to add interaction and link it to destination screen. Do it couple of more times to make interaction complete. Additionally, you can also select device for prototype. To preview prototype, you have to hit little play icon on the top right. Let's try our interaction. If you are following this tutorial, congratulations! You just created your first interaction on Figma. Your design is now ready to share with other designers and stakeholders for a review. Once you share your designs with team members or client for a review, they can use comment section to provide feedbacks on your designs. You can reply to those comments and mark them as results once the task is done. Advanced design tools, collaborating with team, prototyping, version controlling, and a lot of sharing options are present in one single app. And these things make Figma so special. I hope this tutorial helped you understand all the basics of Figma interface and features. Let's dive deep in upcoming videos. If you like this video, like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to hit bell icon. If you want to know more about specific feature or have feedback for me, please let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.